There was never a doubt that this was the other half of me.
So we've been best friends for about
10 years, 11 years, 12 years.
We've taken a lot of trips together.
And we've stayed in some really decrepit dives.
Really?
There was that time that we snuck out of the house when we were 13.
I freaked out. I had a full-on anxiety attack. And she was the only person who could get me through it, so.
And you came to my rescue and saw me at my most vulnerable and weakest and took care of me.
I always need him. Like, I always need to talk to him.
I would probably do anything, I think, to save your life.
If there was a bullet, if there was a train,
I would give him my liver.
If you were bitten by a snake on the butt, I would suck out the poison for you to save your life.
That's extreme.
What if I told you you could save Anna's life right now?
I would say how?
By checking her for breast cancer.
Oh. Wow.
Right now?
Yeah.
This makes me so uncomfortable. Don't touch me.
I mean, they're a great doctor. I could do it. Yeah, I mean.
Oh, you are really talented.
I'm saving your life.
I was going to be like, I'm going to take a bullet for you. But then I should be like, hey, take a breast exam.
Out of all the conversations we've had, we don't remind each other to get breast exams.
We talk about everything else.
Yeah.
We don't think about it.
We should be talking about that.
Now I will.
I will make a pact to you, Kimberly.
To remind each other.
To get a breast exam.
We should make that pledge.
Let's make that pledge.
Every year.
Every year.
If there's any way that you can eliminate losing your best friend, then you should be breast friends.
Boom!
Breast friends! I love you.
I love
so
you.
So please check yourself.